Hello, I am interested in the process by which I could download everything from my brain and upload it into a brain that's inside of the body of Ryan Reynolds. Is that possible? Asking for a friend. Hey there, Brainiacs. Trace here for DNews. Over the centuries, we've compared our brain to clocks, telephone switchboards, and now, of course, computers. But really, the brain is none of these things. It's its own thing. In the upcoming movie Selfless, a dying man uses pretty crazy cool technology to transfer his consciousness into a younger man's body. One would assume that each brain has similar programming for how to run a heart, for example, or manage an immune system, and so on. So we just need the memory data from the person that we're downloading from. But if I wanted to download all the data from one brain and upload it into another brain, would that even be possible? Stephen Hawking thinks so, and futurist Ray Kurzweil believes that we are only 40 years away from doing this. So what's blocking us from starting our first brain backups? What tech do we need? Firstly, we'd have to be able to read from the source brain. Scientists will have to learn how we store these memories. Neurons don't simply store one bit of information like in a computer. Each neuron can create 1,000 connections with those around them, and unlike machines, aren't only on or off, they have other states as well. Luckily, humans are pretty obsessed with mind reading. Researchers at the University of California, Berkeley scanned the brains of people while they were watching videos, and using only the brain scans, a computer was able to determine what those brains were looking at. Using an fMRI scan, the researchers followed blood through the brain. Then they created three-dimensional representations of the scanned areas called voxels, or a three-dimensional pixel. The researchers trained the computer to piece together what that brain was looking at, like, for example, a face that was talking or something that was swimming. Using tech like this, scientists have scanned brains of players of Counter-Strike and saw whether they wanted to turn left or right. But if their character was killed, an emotional response overwhelmed the scan. Emotions are way too complex for us to read, yet. Next, we're gonna have to learn to write to that new brain. When we do that, we're biochemically modifying neurons and their connections to other neurons. There are trillions of these synaptic connections in each person's head. A study in Nature explored exactly how this process works using mice with cells that have been genetically modified to activate when hit with a laser light. This is called optogenetics. With this method, researchers were able to demonstrate how memories are written, erased, and reactivated, and then were able to implant a false memory into another genetically modified mouse. This is pretty incredible stuff, but you can't just do this with any mouse off the street. Yet. So let's assume we do get to a point where we can read and write to our brains reliably. We would need to copy the information from one brain to another. But the human brain isn't a finite storage system like a hard drive. There could be a lot of space in there. Estimates vary from 2.5 petabytes down to a few measly gigabytes themselves. If you wanted to copy 2.5 petabytes over, say, a USB 3.0 connection, it would have to run continuously for more than 80 days. And even over the new Thunderbolt 3 connection, it would take almost a week to copy that data. The biggest issue in consciousness transfer, though, isn't the time or being able to read or write, but it's going to be mapping the brain accurately. Computer scientists from giant companies, major universities, and world governments have been working on mapping and translating the brain network to a computer network for decades. But thoughts don't live on a single neuron, nor are they processed in a single place, but rather as a patterned network of brain cells that pick up the information and process it. We're at the fundamental level of brain mapping already. We've got a while to go until we can map all the connections and states of all our individual neurons at one time, in real time. But just imagine where we'll be in a few more decades, considering where we are already. Billions of dollars are being spent on this, and according to top minds in the field, it is only a matter of time until we learn to emulate a brain in a computer and then map a consciousness on top of it. Based on what we know now, maybe we aren't too far from that brain copying future after all. Selfless hits theaters on July 10th and will star Ben Kingsley and Ryan Reynolds. In this sci-fi tale, an extremely wealthy man dying from cancer undergoes a radical medical procedure that transfers his consciousness into the body of a healthy young man. Looks like a pretty cool movie. If you could, would you extend your life with a consciousness transfer? You can tell us down in the comments, or you can come find us on Twitter as well. We're at DNews. Make sure you subscribe for more videos every day. Thanks for watching.